Live from Sheryl's living room, it's Horror Queer News. Your co-host, Cheryl. And Cheryl, America's best friend.
Hello, folks. Tonight on Horror Queer News, we have our breaking stories.
And by breaking, we mean broken.
Wind. Breaking news.
God, why is Satan controlling the universe?
In Provincetown, club kid street urchins with fangs and amazing coats killing people.
So it's carnival again?
Yes, why is everyone freaking out for? Oh, it's the winter. From very close sources that would like to remain anonymous, we've heard terrible stories. People taking pills and children performing atrocities. Not since the incident at the Cracker Barrel have we seen trouble like this, Cheryl.
We received an anonymous tip from someone who was, quote, feeling the colors on the beach, who said that he saw someone eating someone's neck. Neck doesn't even taste good.
You should have fallen in love with old Cape Cod.
Hey everyone, time for another exciting episode of American Horror Story Season 10, double feature, episode 6, the finale of Red Tide. Winter kills, and doesn't it?
Yes, winter does kill. Just ask Jack Nicholson.
Or you can ask Leo DiCaprio. Just like almost Macaulay Culkin's little sister in The Good Son.
He knew the ice would break.
What a film.
So Doris is all up in these streets, bald-headed and looking for things to feast on.
I'm so into blood right now.
And whether everybody knows it or not, everybody seems to be being controlled by Ursula, this Hollywood head honcho.
Playing puppet master.
She pulling strings, but you know what happens when you got all these puppets on the strings? They start getting all tangled, then you start looking like a fool.
Then you gotta cut some loose.
Oh, won't you join us under Dick Duck for the finale of Red Tide?
Strap on your blood bags and file down your teeth. We're about to finish this out. I can smell this scene.
Tony, where you headed?
Whistling Pete.
Is this the guy that got swallowed by that whale?
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Permission to change their shingles from our traditional Simply White,
white
to Mountain Peak White.
Who?
Chairwoman, Council, I'm Trooper Jan Remy.
Jan!
Let the state police into your murdered chief.
I thought the chief was just missing, but
she was.
From Glee.
Until a fisherman. I just examined the chief's body and observed the exact same wound pattern.
I don't know why we would make a big fuss when we don't even know if there's a problem.
Your chief was brutally murdered and thrown in the harbor. Do you think the sharks and the boat propellers somehow came on land?
We really appreciate what you're trying
why
to do.
Why is there such a preservation of this?
I have feel like money has to do with this.
And we're saying that everyone in this room depends upon the summer to pay for the winter. All of those city folk who drive down for the weekend in July to spend all of that sweet city money get spooked and decide that maybe the
you're literally confirming that something fucked up's happening, but okay.
The gays might stop coming.
Gay gas!
You're all hiding something. You know something.
We know what's best for this community.
I'll take care of it.
I just hate all of them. What a bop. Every time it's a bop.
It's a bop.
This winter has been completely out of control.
It's not us, it's the Hollywood people. They ruin everything.
This is really it, Harry. I mean, this is your masterpiece. It's your Moby Dick, your Romeo and Juliet, your Godfather.
Those are all on the same level?
We're done.
Mm-mm.
So now that you're done with your masterpiece, we all have to stop?
It's not like that.
All of a sudden?
They're not gonna let him do everything I've done too easily.
This is what success feels like, Harry. It feels like superiority.
I can just be a dad to you and your brother. We can do this the right
way. Oh yeah, there's a baby.
It just sets the truth. I love you so much, honey.
He's gonna have to kill that little girl.
She's gonna kill him.
Oh! And she just told her that she wants to do it with her eyes. That was some eye acting.
Someone break in.
Oh.
Uh
I know.
Don't worry, you'll be safe and sound and snug as a bug. But if you aren't at my house by sunset, that will change. See you later, Belle.
And on such beautiful stationery.
You need to go to Belle's and face them, but not with me. I'm not going with you.
She did it.
She can shit, little bitch.
Okay. I know you got a raw deal.
She's talking to everybody.
But you are not monsters. You're a bunch of Lawrence Fishburns. And that's what I'm here to offer you, a second chance. There's a new pill with a new formula. Not only is it more potent than the last pill, but it has no side effects. You can be cured. You don't have to live.
What is the play here?
Yeah, is this true? Where did this come from?
Every success they have is a slap in your face.
Here we go. All right.
Whatever you're thinking of doing, just let me take my kids and leave town. I swear you will never hear from us again. Mm. Listen, I just finished writing something and it's gonna be huge. I don't need the pills anymore.
P-Town is a welcoming place, but you fucked it up.
Dad.
The locals back there were right and so are we. But unlike them, we're going to clean up this town!
Oh.
The baby!
Angelica Ross!
War! Oh. The talented versus the untalented, folks. Damn, that was the original guy. Oh!
There goes that theater.
Woo! Vampire Marge! R.I.P. Alexa, play That's What You Get by Paramore.
The cop?
Nope.
Oh! What about Lawrence Fishburne?
Some of the critics have kind of been a little bit lukewarm in that. Oh,
that went better than expected.
I don't trust Earth. Ursula has some sort of plan for this.
We're gonna be all right.
But it's just gonna be the two of us.
Ursula and her.
Gotta be the greatest. I can't let you stop me.
Say it ain't so.
I don't think I'll ever get used to that.
That's a loss. Could have been the next Sork and it's fucking tragic.
We don't need that much dialogue in this world.
So?
You really think the state trooper's gonna believe this story? That he killed all of them?
Well, it's gonna take a little dressing. Hollywood writer, under pressure and doing drugs, going all Manson. I think that's a story I can sell.
You went full Shining on him?
First, there's a whole city bursting with talent just waiting to shell out for a boost.
Do you mind? I don't like people watching me while I eat.
Well, you should have took it in another room, you little bitch!
Hollywood, 3 months later. Whoa! Buddy!
Why did you walk by so many people?
And did he get infected?
That literally would never happen, but okay.
Each of the dead officers are well-known members of what police reform activists call the Bad Apple List, an unofficial database of LAPD officers with multiple race-based complaints filed against them.
Megan Miranda, more on this story.
And she's using it to get rid of them. Wow.
Every one of those pricks had no business protecting and serving. Racist, sadistic garbage. That means IDing the worst cops in the city, sneaking them a little bit of my magic medicine, and sitting back and smiling. You're all of 5 years old trying to tell me how to be.
I'm 9.
You want to make it to 10?
They seem very touched.
One of them does. Ugly dress.
You're making it a very hard choice. You're both wonderful.
I'm better than you.
Excuse me?
There are no others like me.
I guess that's true, but you think that's a good thing. It becomes a freak show.
He's definitely just fucking with her, but I love it.
It's so pageant. How?
She doesn't have one drop on that white collar.
Greatness comes with
with the price. How much do you want it? Are you ready to bleed? I'd like all of you to reach under your seats right now. There's a little something special under there.
I'd be like, what? It
looks like a pill.
I can't do it. I got it. It's going to...
Just don't say no.
Wait. I'm sorry. You didn't tell me about this.
You teach a screenwriting class. Have you ever sold a fucking script?
Yes.
One. A failed Orion Stallone flick back in 88? You know nothing. It's just one swallow away. Spit or swallow, the choice is yours.
Is it spits or swallows, dear?
Dang.
Your future.
Yeah! Oh! Damn.
The streets are running red with blood and metaphors. At least all of those no-talent monsters are taking their pain out in the real way. At least now, we're leveling the playing field.
Final thought.
So, a lot of death.
Tis the end of Red Tide. They wrapped that shit up with a nice bloody bow.
Doris is still shambling through a graveyard in Provincetown eating bunnies.
But she's out there. Honestly, she's probably better off without those two fuckers. She's saving money on conditioner.
No, you know what? That is a missed opportunity. Why didn't they have Doris show up at the end and then like Harry had to kill her or something, or Alma had to kill her? Then Evan Peters and Francis Conroy were like, well, 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 if it isn't the consequences of my own actions. They had it coming.
Like, come see my magical, fantastic, elixir-filled, organic,
vegan,
cinnamon, toasted,
frosted,
Diet Pepsi dunked,
zero calorie,
fried, came out of Dolly Parton's butthole, diamond studded, jewel encrusted,
chocolate chip,
wet, black pills, they'll make you uber talented.
When I see you smiling, I go, oh, oh, oh.
Or not.
Probably not.
I feel like they did wrap everything up a little quickly in the end of this, just like they do in a lot of other seasons of American Horror Story, but it wasn't as bad. Sometimes other seasons, they wrap everything up so fast in the last episode or two, and it's like, oh, yikes. Because this isn't like the true end of this season, it was nice to like wrap it up here so we can get to the next part, and we'll see how it all connects. Fuck those townspeople, though. I kind of wanted to see the townspeople get their comeuppance, because they're just preserving shit that ain't even good.
Even from episode one, we wish death on bad Boston accent, maybe.
Don't try and imitate a Boston accent.
Huh? A debauchery.
Overall thoughts this season, I feel like this was a solid first half of the season. I also think it's the best season we've had so far since, I don't know, maybe Hotel or something. I'm very into the story of this season, and I think that they're really trying for us for season 10.
I liked that not only did we get a condensed full story in half of the season, but they even took the time in the second to last episode to do some wrapping up, so they didn't have to do it all in the finale.
Yeah, it's like Macaulay Culkin and Sarah Paulson, and you know, like, not gonna lie, especially because they were gone, I think those might have been my favorite characters, to be honest, so.
Definitely.
Yeah, I don't know if either one of those actors is returning in the second half, but we'll see.
I did learn something from this first half of American Horror Story.
And what's that, Cheryl?
That children are evil.
Thank you for joining us on our little cruise on the Red Tides. But do check back as we enter Death Valley, the second part of Double Feature.
That sounds hot.
Don't make us watch alone. Don't make us watch alone.
This is actually perfect because I was going to have a doctor look at my Death Valley.
Oh.
Bayonara.
Fuck face!